Hi everyone. So we have recently introduced our HFFC application on Play Store for Android and iOS users. All you need to do is go to the Google Play Store for Android users and App Store for iOS users and type HFFC Customer Portal, download the application and just register. We have already shared a demo video for the same on how to register on HFFC application. The link of the video is available in the description below. All right, I'll show you the demo and take you through the entire application. So let's start with the login. So I'll enter the registered mobile number first. So you'll have to make sure that you enter a contact number of the primary applicant, the main loan holder. So the primary applicant, which is the main loan holder, you'll have to enter the contact number. So I enter the contact number. Next is the password. So you'll have to enter the password set by you. Enter the password. Okay. The next step is login. Okay. So finally we are inside the application. So once you are logged in successfully, it will take you to the dashboard screen. So this is the dashboard screen. Okay. All you can see is this dashboard is divided into multiple sections, where each section gives you a separate detail about your selected loan account number. So if you have like more than one loan, then you can, and if you want to check the details of a particular loan account, then you can simply click on this navigation arrow like this. So it will change the loan account. And then you can simply check the loan details of a particular loan account. Okay, so for example, if I want to check the loan account or loan information of a particular loan account number, I can simply click on the screen like this, and then it can take me to the loan details of this loan account number. As you can see on the screen, the loan account number here is 39338 and the details are here. So I'll go back. Okay. So the next section that we have on the dashboard is payments. So this is the current month's due amount, and it will show you the loan outstanding amount of a particular loan account number. So for example, if you have already cleared, I'll just go back. Okay, so this is the screen. Okay, so let me take some other loan account number. Okay, so on this payment section, if the amount showing is 1860, despite of the fact that you've already cleared it, then you can ignore it. But if it's bounced due to insufficient funds or any other reason, any other technical issue, then you can directly make the payment from the application itself. Just click on make a payment like this. Enter your particular loan account number. So I'll select 51964. Okay. So it will show few details, which is auto-filled. Like here, it's the loyalty top-up. Here the nature of payment would be EMI, since you want to make the payment for EMI. And then here you can simply enter the amount. So if I want to pay it, then I can simply click on pay. It will, once you click on pay, it will take you to the payment gateway wherein you are supposed to enter all the bank details, and then you can make the payment. So I just go back and let's check the next section, which is our service request. Okay. So when I click on the service request, it will show me the pending and the closed service request. So service request will show me all the service requests which has been processed till date and the request which is still pending for resolution. So if I want to check on all the closed requests, I can simply click on closed, and here you can scroll down. So these are all the requests which has been closed and resolved. And then when I click on pending, it shows the request for the account statement which is pending, which is still not processed. So you can check an update from the application itself. So now if I want to raise a new service request, I can simply click on this plus sign. Wait, I'll show you again. Okay, on this plus sign. Now here, if you want to raise a, say for example, here I'll give you a demo for document request. So I want to raise the document request for interest certificate. So now here I'll select the loan account number. Next, the request type could be the document request. Category has to be interest certificate. Subject, I can mention the year, the financial year. Say for example, I want it for 17-18. Okay. So next thing is I can also include the description if I want to. And then it's anyways optional, so you can skip it. And then next I can click on submit. So here it has to validate your request. So for that matter, you'll have to enter the password. So I'll enter the password and click on proceed. Okay, so my request has been successfully registered. Okay, so I'll click on okay and I'll go back. So now you can see the pending request that I have is, one is the account statement that was visible earlier, and now it has interest certificate too. So this is how you can raise a service request using HFFC application. Okay, so let's just go back and explore the next section. So the next section that we have is disbursement. So let's just click on disbursement. So when I go on to the disbursement tab, so it will give me the details of how much amount has been funded till date out of the loan amount and how much amount is pending for disbursement. So as you scroll down, it will give you the details like the amount funded. It will give you the minute detail like the amount funded till date, the reference ID, transaction ID and the date of transaction. So you can check the disbursement details for different loan accounts. I'll go back. So the next section that we have is profile. You just click on the section. So here you can check all your updated details like your current mailing address, your contact number, email ID, details of your loan account holders. So one is for the main applicant, the other one is for the co-applicants. So you can check it from here. Just a second. Okay, so if I want to edit it, so if I want to edit any of one of the detail, I can simply click on edit, and from here I can change the password, the mobile number and the current mailing address using the HFFC application. So I'll go back, I close it. So if I want to be specific, say for example, if I want the only loan related information, then I can simply navigate to the loan tab, and here I can get the details of my loan account. And the same goes for disbursement, and the same goes for payment. Okay, so let's just go back to the dashboard. Okay, so the next thing that we have is more. So now here, as you can see, one is service request, which has already been discussed, all your closed and pending requests, will be available in your service request tab. Your legal credits, anything which is related to terms and conditions, policies, you can check it from here. Then about is our social media presence. If you want to like, share or follow us, you can do it from the application itself. Let's just go back. So when I go to settings, again it will help me out in changing the password, mobile number and address. So I'll go back. The next thing that we have is logout. So if you are done with the information, we can simply click on logout and click on yes. So if I am getting this message, you are successfully logged out. You have to click OK. So we are finally out of the HFFC application. So that's about the application. If you have any queries that we have not addressed in this video, feel free to post your comments below in the box provided. And don't forget to download and register this HFFC application. Thank you so much.